Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to Cert Bros. In this video, we're going to be looking at binary. Okay, so in the last video, we looked at IP addresses, what they are and what they do. In this video, we're going to take it up a notch. Binary is how computers process data. And it's just a whole bunch of ones and zeros. You've likely seen or heard about binary, especially in those cheesy hacker or cybersecurity videos. It can look intimidating at first, but it's actually very simple. An IP version 4 address is 32 bits long. This means the address is made up of 32 binary digits. Each digit is called a bit. The IP address contains 4 octets. Each octet contains 8 binary bits. When we type in an IP address, the computer will convert that into binary. And to fully understand how IP addresses work, we need to be able to do the same. We're going to use just one octet for our conversion, and then the same process is repeated for the rest of the IP address. So here we have 8 binary bits. These bits can either be a 1 or a 0. So how do we make numbers like 192 from 1s and 0s? Well, each bit represents a value. The value doubles in size from right to left. This is called the power of 2. Using this chart, we can see each bit is assigned its own column. It's important to know that 1 means on and 0 means off. This means we can turn columns on or off just by adding either a 1 or a 0. So let's try it. All of our columns currently have a 0, which means they're all off. What value does 8 zeros give us? Well, because all columns are off, there's nothing to add up, so our binary value is 0. If we turn on the 1 column by adding a 1, what value does that give us? It gives us 1. If we put a 1 in the 2 column, that gives us a value of 2. Pretty straightforward so far, right? Okay, this time, let's turn on the 1 and the 2 column. What do we do here? We need to add up all of the columns that have a 1. So our value here would be 3. Hopefully that makes sense. Let's try one that's a bit more difficult. Our binary value is 00101101. Again, we just need to add up all of our columns. 32 plus 8 equals 40, plus 4, so that's 44, plus 1 equals 45. So 45 is our number. Okay, so now we've gone over the basics, let's bring in an IP address and convert it to binary. Remember, there are 8 bits in each octet, so we're going to do this one at a time. The first number in our IP address is 192. So this is the number we need to generate from our binary bits. We always start with the highest value we can. In this case, 128, so we put a 1 in that column. That leaves us with 64 remaining, and that just so happens to be the next column. So we'll add a 1 there as well. This means our binary value for 192 is 11000000. The next number in our IP address is 54. Again, we start with the highest number possible. This time, that's 32. That leaves us with 22. So we can add 16. Then we're left with 6. We can get that by adding the 4 and then the 2. And that's it. So the binary value for 54 is 00110110. The next number is 103. If you think you're getting the idea by now, try pausing the video, writing out this power of 2 chart, and trying to work out how to get 103. It's okay, we'll wait. Okay, that's long enough. We start with 64 because that's the highest value we can use. Add 32, That gives us 96. So only 7 left to go. We'll add 4, 2, and 1. Meaning the answer is 01100111. And the last one to do is 29. So we need 16, 8, 4, and 1. Meaning our last binary value is 00011101. And we have now converted our IP address into binary. Don't worry though, this isn't something you'll need to do all of the time. But it is extremely important that you understand how this works, especially as we progress. If you're not great with maths, again, don't worry. The more you practice this, you will start to memorize it. Without thinking, you'll know that 128 plus 64 equals 192. Okay, so moving on. In the last video, we spoke about how an IP address is split into a network section and a host section. The way we know which is with a subnet mask. Our IP is a class C address, so we should know that the default subnet mask is 255.255.255.0. Previously, I said wherever there's a 255, this is the network section, and wherever there is a 0, this is the host section. And that's true in the simplest form. However, it can get a bit more complicated than that. The real way to see which part of an IP address is the network section is by looking at the subnet mask binary bits. Anytime you see a 1, this bit is the network section. Anytime you see a 0, this is the host section. I know it may seem overkill with this example, but as we move on into subnetting, it's extremely important you understand how this works. Now, instead of a full subnet mask, you will often see it written as a forward slash and then the number of network bits. In this case, instead of 255.255.255.0, we could write it as slash 24. This is usually added to the end of the IP address. Let's take a closer look at the host section. You can see we have 8 bits. Thinking back to our chart, how many host addresses can we have with 8 bits? We can have all zeros, all ones, or anything in between. 255 is the number we get if we add up all of the columns. This means we have a total number of 256 possible combinations, and that's including 0. There is a catch though. You cannot use the first or last IP address for a host. These are reserved. The first address, in this case 192.54.103.0, is the network address. And the last address, 192.54.103.255, is a broadcast address. This is used to send messages to all computers in this network. So we only have 254 usable hosts. So just remember, you cannot assign the first or the last address to a host. Okay, so that's the basics of binary. We'll be using this a lot as we go, especially when we move on to subnetting. This video is part of our full CCNA course, which can be found in the description. So please feel free to go and check it out. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, comment, and subscribe. The support from you guys really does help the channel grow. Other than that, I hope this video helped, and thank you for watching.